Let's have a look at some of the additional features that you can make use of when using drum racks on Push. I have a drum rack with 16 different percussive sounds and a basic rhythm playing. And what I'd like to do is show you some of the advanced features that you can use when playing drums. The first thing I'd like to do is to change the color of some of the pads. This is really helpful because it helps you to remember what type of percussive sounds you have in each of the pads. I'll hold the shift button and select a pad to change the color. Once I've changed the color of that particular pad, you can also see that the notes in the step sequencer also take on the same color. If I wish to customize my current drum rack, I can also swap out the sounds in each of the pads. I have a percussive sound here that I'd like to remove. I'll simply hold down the delete button and tap that pad to delete that particular sound. I'd like to replace this empty pad now with a new sample. So now, having selected the simpler of that empty pad, I'll press Browse and search for a new sample to load into the empty pad space. Now let's have a look at 16 velocities. I have some rim shots here, and I'd like to play some ghost notes and make the sound a little bit more dynamic. I'll press the layout button to enter the 16 velocities. Now I can play my rimshot sound with 16 different velocities of volume. So I'm going to record some additional rimshot sounds. To do this, I'll simply press the record button and wait for the counting. Another way I can make use of the 16 velocities is using the repeat button. I'll hold down the select button to select my hi-hat sound without actually hearing it, and toggle on the repeat. Now I can play the hi-hat notes with different velocities. I can also use the 16 velocities to input notes into the step sequencer. So again, using the hi-hats, I'm going to hold down the select button and select a particular velocity from the 16 velocities and then enter those notes into the step sequencer. If I wish to change the velocities of the current notes that I've put into the step sequencer, I can also hold down the notes and then choose the velocity from the 16 velocity levels which I want to actually use.